Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at a pretty eye-catching CPU air cooler from a brand that, if you're like me and you've been tinkering with PC hardware for a long time, should be a brand that rings a bell. I'm talking about Zalman, where they were really popular for their CNPS series of so-called flower coolers that were the gold standard for its time. And these images on the screen should really evoke some halcyon memories of the Intel Pentium D and AMD Athlon 64 days, which are around 20 years ago now. For today's video, I have with me the Z5 CPU cooler, which sort of pays homage to the brand's flower cooler lineup with its sleek jet engine inspired design. Let's see if the Z5 is any good. Now for those of you who are not in the know, Zalman is a South Korean brand that was founded in 1999 and became really popular in the early 2000s, all thanks to their innovative flower coolers that really stood out from the CPU coolers of that time. The brand then encountered a whole host of high-profile company issues from the mid-2010s and somewhat maintained a relatively low profile since then. At Computex 2025 this year, they made ways for their ZET, or ZET series of CPU coolers that were inspired by the design of a jet turbine engine. And we have here the first ZET series of coolers to be launched for sale, the Z5. With that, let's have a look at the packaging. The Z5 comes shipped in a brown cardboard box with the usual product descriptions and illustrations on all sides of the box. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. Right, so opening up the box, we catch a glimpse of some cartoon characters right here. In case you're wondering, Mansu and Mansters are Zalman's new brand mascots. We see that within the cardboard box, we get a galactic-themed cylindrical plastic container that holds the Z5 cooler. Let's set this aside for now to see what else Zalman's included with the cooler. Now at the bottom of the cardboard box, you get a smaller square cardboard box with a whole bunch of accessories. We've got some documentation here, starting first with an instruction manual, as well as a marketing leaflet in the shape of a boarding pass. Let's have a look at what's inside of this cardboard box. We've got thermal paste, we've got mounting hardware and the like. Let's open up the bag to take a look at its contents. Right, so I've laid out the accessories so that we can see what exactly has been included. Naturally, we get the requisite AMD and Intel mounting hardware. We're talking about brackets, standoffs, backplate and so on. Nothing out of the ordinary here. Zalman's also included a tube of their ZM STC10 thermal paste, a user manual, and a marketing leaflet in the shape of a boarding pass that features Mansu and Mansters. Let's take a closer look at the Z5 by first getting it out of the box. Right, so the Z5 has a very distinctive jet turbine inspired design, where as can be seen, it has dual fans, as well as a cowl that's made of plastic. We also get an ARGB lighting ring for each fan, like so. And these are accompanied by an ARGB LED strip right down the center. We also get the Zalman wordmark and logos right here, which reminds me of the way aircraft engine manufacturers would display their brands on commercial jet turbine engine covers. Now the dual 120mm fans attach to the main cooler tower by means of magnets, where as can be seen, they use a pogo pin connection system for the fan power and ARGB LEDs. Taking a closer look at the included fans, They feature what Zalman terms an annular fan design that improves efficiency and stability. The fans feature a RPM range of between 600 to 2000 RPM, a CFM rating of 44.48, and a supposed maximum noise level of no more than 30.4 decibels. The Z5 uses a typical 4-pin PWM connector, as well as a 3-pin addressable RGB connector that runs to the main cooler tower, like so. Moving over to the bottom of the cooling tower, we see that the Z5 features 5 reverse direct touch heat pipes, or RDTH for short, which have a chrome finish. Now, another feature that Zalman touts is the use of direct soldering between the heat pipes and heatsink assembly so as to enhance heat transfer efficiency. With that, here's a quick summary of some of the key specs for the Z5. As can be seen on the screen, the Z5 has a rated TDP of 200 watts and is also available in a white colorway for you folks intending to put together a PC build in white. Now, to benchmark the cooling prowess for this CPU cooler, I'll be installing it on my AM5 test bench that is powered by an AMD Ryzen 7 7800X3D processor. I'll then run some benchmarks to see how the Z5's performance is like. Let's get the Z5 installed on the test bench. Now, the installation process for this CPU cooler on the AM5 platform, or AM4 for that matter, seeing as both platforms do share the same mounting mechanism for a CPU cooler, it's pretty straightforward, where you've got to mount the appropriate mounting hardware onto your motherboard. With an AM5 or AM4 motherboard, the Z5 utilizes the stock AMD backplate that comes included with your motherboard, and you can simply install the correct standoffs, followed by the AMD mounting brackets, like so. After applying the included ZM STC10 thermal paste that comes included with the Z5 Black, installing the cooling tower onto the motherboard is just a matter of securing two Phillips head screws to the screw posts on the two mounting brackets that you just installed. Thereafter, simply reattach the two cooling fans to the cooling tower, connect the PWM and addressable RGB connectors to your motherboard, and you're good to go. For you folks using Intel systems, the installation process is very similar to the AMD setup process, with the key difference being that you'll need to install this motherboard backplate that comes included with the Z5 first, before proceeding to install the four standoffs and mounting brackets like with the AMD setup, and thereafter, mounting the cooling tower accordingly. It's worth noting that the included Intel backplate has adjustable ends so as to fit either a LGA 1200 motherboard or a LGA 1700 or LGA 1851 motherboard. The LGA 1700 and LGA 1851 sockets both share the same mounting hole positions for a CPU cooler, and I have here on the screen an ASUS ROG Strix Z890A gaming Wi-Fi motherboard that's designed for Intel's latest Core Ultra 200 series of processors. Now, for this installation demo, I don't have an actual Intel processor installed on the board. Securing the cooler to the motherboard is a simple matter of tightening the two Phillips head screws to the screw posts on the mounting brackets. And here we have it, the Z5 all set up on the test bench. In terms of its RGB lighting effects, I personally quite like the fan's aesthetics, especially with the ARGB lighting rings that do add some character to the CPU cooler's overall appearance. Here's a summary on the specs of the test bench that I'll be using to test the Z5 with. where I'll be using it to cool an AMD Ryzen 7 7800X3D processor, which has a default TDP of 120 watts. For the purposes of testing the CPU cooler, I've left the fan curves on their stock default settings. To put the Z5 through its paces, I'll be running Cinebench 2024's multi-core test to see how the 7800X3D's thermals are going to be like. Thereafter, I'll be running F1 23's in-game benchmark test so as to see how thermals are going to be like under a typical gaming workload, and I'll also take a look at how temperatures are like when the test bench is idle. Finally, to round off this review, we'll take a look at the acoustic performance of the Z5 when idle and under the Cinebench 2024 multi-core workload. Let's get started! First up, we've got Cinebench 2024's multi-core test, where the Ryzen 7 7800X3D achieved a score of 1039, with an average CPU temperature reading of 83 degrees Celsius, a low of 81.4 degrees Celsius, and a high of 83.1 degrees Celsius. Moving on to F1 23's in-game benchmark test, where I ran a 5-lap test for around 9 minutes in total, the 7800X3D achieved an average CPU temperature of 59.2 degrees Celsius, a low of 56 degrees Celsius, and a high of 74.4 degrees Celsius with the Z5. Just to highlight once again, these benchmark tests were carried out in a non-air conditioned room with an ambient temperature of around 30.5 degrees Celsius. In terms of idle temperatures, the Ryzen 7 7800X3D achieved an average CPU temperature reading of around 46.2 degrees Celsius, with a low of 44.1 degrees Celsius and a high of 53 degrees Celsius. Moving on to acoustics and fan noise, the room that I tested the Z5 in had an ambient noise level of around 49 decibels. With that in mind, my decibel meter recorded 51.9 decibels of noise when the test bench was idle, and when running Cinebench 2024's multi-core test, the decibel meter recorded 55 decibels of noise. Again, do bear in mind that I used an open-air test bench for benchmarking purposes and had my decibel meter placed around 30 cm away from the Z5. To sum things up, given the Zalman Z5's thermal performance, it's clearly designed for use with mid-range processors such as AMD's Ryzen 5 or Ryzen 7 X3D offerings, and perhaps Intel's Core i5 and Core Ultra 5 lineup. The Z5's key selling point would be its looks for sure. I think it's quite safe to say I haven't seen any other air coolers in town with such an eye-catching aesthetic, where given that it's not overly wide as well, it allows you to showcase your RGB RAMs with ease too. As of the time of publishing this review, the Z5 Black is available to purchase in Singapore for a price of around SGD 95. For you international viewers, I'm not sure if the Z5 is available in places such as the United States or Europe as of yet, but SGD 95 converts to roughly $73, which is on the pricier side of things for sure. That's it, I can see how this cooler would still appeal to folks who are really sold on its aesthetics and might not mind paying a price premium, especially nostalgia chasers who might have used Zalman's flower coolers of yesteryear. But do note that in doing so, you do trade some thermal performance for looks. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.